Hello, welcome to Tribune Videos. At the Military Literature Festival in Chandigarh, we are with two very inspiring women in uniform, Major Poonam Sangwan and Major Namrata Rathore. Not only they are serving the Indian Army, but they also hold the credit of climbing the Mount Everest. Let's know from them the journey about it. Major Poonam, what made you go for the Everest hike climb?
I would rather say the opportunity of going to the Everest came to me and for all of us at the right time, and we were fortunate enough to get this opportunity and grab this opportunity and be part of the elite or the illustrious Everest expedition, which is the most successful expedition till date of the Indian Army.
What were the best moments and the toughest moments of this expedition?
The entire journey, I would say there are many instances which are takeaways. The best moment was just to stand on the top and just look around that yes, we have finally made it.
And what was the toughest part of this expedition for you?
The training, including the summer training, the winter training, the training was, yes, it was very tough, and we were trained for almost, I think, 10 times more difficulties which we actually faced. However, the difficulties faced in Everest were also, it was very, very difficult, but the training part, it was very, very difficult, and we were ruthlessly trained.
Major Namrata, did it help that you were part of the Indian Army to climb the Everest, because there were many hikers trying to climb the summit at the same time?
Yes, definitely. Like, the Everest expedition, like she said, it came to us because of Army only. Initially, yes, we were active in sport. In training, Army made us physically fit. But as far as the mountaineering is concerned, just because of the expedition which Army has planned, and we happen to be the fortunate one to be a part of it. Otherwise, it would definitely not be in the cards, like if we were not aware of such kind of field, or we were not aware of this opportunity. It would not have happened earlier.
What was different in your training that was different from other people who failed this expedition?
It's the right place at the right time. We also were not successful in our first attempt. On 19th May, though we were standing at Camp 4, we were standing at 8,000 meter. But still, just 800 below the summit, we were not able to reach the top. So we have thought that the opportunity is not there for us, and we were made to came back to Camp 2. But yes, the training helped us, because already standing at the 8,000 means that you are already summiting a peak. But we came back, we have lost all the energy which we have. But the thing which we have not lost was the mental strength. I'll say mental toughness is much, much more required than your physical. Because you will train your body with all the physical training. But if you not have that mental fitness, because the environmental conditions are such that at one point of time, your body will say, boss, this is my limit. But at that particular time, your mind takes you one more step ahead. Like when your body will say, I cannot move even a single step ahead, at that time your mind will tell you, no, your aim is something else. You have 10 more steps you have to take to reach over there. And that's how your brain will take over your body, and that's how you move ahead. So I'll say the mental training is more important than the physical training, because after a certain period of time, everybody is at the equal level as far as the physical fitness is concerned. But those who reach the top, those who submit the Everest, they are the one who are much more mentally tougher than the physical ones.
I have one more question.
I would add in this.
Yes, please.
Apart from the leadership, the training, I would say it was the leadership which we are taught in the Army, and we are trained for that. The leadership of our team leader, the training part which we had undergone, and the sheer determination and dedication which we as the men and women in uniform have. That was the cutting edge which we had, and apart from the other climbers, who unfortunately some of them could not succeed. However, we succeeded because of these few factors: the leadership, the training, dedication, determination, and the mental strength what she brought up.
For the young girls who want to don olive greens, what it takes?
I must say it is the best organization to serve in, and women are doing exceedingly well in this organization, and it is the organization also which is giving equal opportunities to men and women irrespective of the gender, and I can only say they must come and join the forces.
And secondly, it's basically just have to dream, because everything is possible in this world. You just have to dream, and you have to dream of the day, then you will actually convert your dream into a reality. So if you want to achieve something, you just have to think for it and just move ahead in that direction, and just don't let your feet stop. That's all. You want to join army, that's one of the best organization. Other than you want to do anything in this world, it's just your mental thought process and your determination and your hard work which will take you ahead.
Thank you so very much. This is Mona with Rajiv Bhatia for the Tribune.